Gamification is about making tasks fun and motivating through game elements. Every fight made Jinwoo stronger. Every routine makes you sharper. You don't respawn, but you do evolve. Welcome once again to the LiFE RPG introduction video. In this chapter, I will explain how to use the task manager feature of LiFE RPG and share various use cases of Para Dashboard in daily life. But please note that this isn't a complete tutorial. For a more in-depth guide, you can find full tutorial videos on the official LiFE RPG resource page. Let's get started. First, let me explain the definition of stage para in LiFE RPG. Stage and quest is essentially a para dashboard, with the main difference being that it has a reward system. If you have ever used a para dashboard to manage your tasks, then this should not be difficult for you. The game terminology includes skills, which represent the areas in the para method, stages, which represent projects under an area, and quests, which are the tasks within a project. Next, I will explain what the para method is. If you're already familiar with it, feel free to skip ahead to this point in the video. What is para? The para method, developed by Tiago Forte, is a straightforward approach to managing digital information. It categorizes information into four main categories: projects, areas, resources, and archive. First, let's look at this hierarchy chart. From here, we can see that an area can contain many projects, and a project can contain many tasks. An area is defined as an important aspect of your life and your long-term responsibilities, such as writing, health, video production, etc. In LiFE RPG, we define this as your character skill. A project is a short-term work project, such as creating a YouTube video. A task can be understood as the to-do list items under your project, such as writing the video script, shooting the video, and video editing. Resources can be understood as the information for your project or area. Finally, there is the archive. The simplest way to understand it is that it contains all the projects, tasks, or resources that you no longer need. For example, if I have completed the video How to Use Notion, I can move this project to the archive. A few months later, if I want to review the production of this video, I can always check my past projects in the archive database. LiFE RPG has made some modifications based on the para method. If you want to learn more about the para method, you can visit the official para method website for more information. After understanding the para method, I will now show you how to use the para dashboard in LiFE RPG. Let's review the examples mentioned earlier. I want to use this para method to manage my YouTube channel. First, in the skill and area section of the para dashboard, add the skill video production. Each newly created area will come with a project database view where we can add or manage all related projects under that area. For example, creating a video on how to use Notion. We can also drag and drop the project pages to quickly update the current status of the project. Open the project page where we can fill in the start date, due date, priority, and how much experience points and coins your character and skills will gain upon completing this project. Moving down, we can see the tasks database view where we can add tasks related to this project. For example, video editing, video scripting, etc. In this view, I can add a priority to this task. Just like with projects, I can also drag and drop tasks to reflect my current progress. Scroll down and you can set the action date in the task scheduler module. Once set, the system will automatically calculate your due date and the remaining days. When you complete a task, click the Quest Complete button to see that the system has already sent the rewards to your character in the activity log. To minimize the time users spend on manual data entry, each task's rewards are linked to the project. You only need to enter the rewards once when creating the project, and the system will automatically distribute the set rewards evenly among the tasks under this project. So you don't need to set rewards 100 times for 100 tasks. Brain Dump is a place to temporarily store your to-do list. You can add tasks to Brain Dump instantly through your phone or the homepage of LiFE RPG, whenever you think of something to do. Tasks in Brain Dump may just be reminders or daily tasks, such as replying to emails or buying dog food. They may not belong to any specific project. Select the task's difficulty level and the skill related to it. When you complete the tasks, the skill will gain experience point based on the chosen difficulty. After completing a task in Brain Dump, click the Completed button, and the task will automatically be hidden from the list. You can view completed tasks by accessing this tab. Some tasks listed in Brain Dump may belong to a specific project. You can then move these tasks from Brain Dump to your inbox in the Para dashboard for further organization. Now, I will demonstrate the daily use of this dashboard. At the top, we have quick add buttons that allow you to quickly add new tasks, projects, or resources to the database. If we don't have time to fill in the details, we can simply close the page and come back to it later. Each newly added project, task, and resource is preset to the inbox state. The inbox view is where we can view and work with these temporary captures. To stay organized, allocate time each day to process the items in your inbox. Move it out of inbox status after assigning relevant details and attributes as needed. When we start working, we can open the Today tab view to see the tasks that need to be completed that day. After completing these tasks, click the Quest Complete button, and your task will receive the set EXP and coins. Resources can be understood as the information for your project or area. For example, I want to create a video about how to use Notion. I need to search for information about Notion on Google. If I find an article on the internet that helps me with my current project, I can add it to my resources using the Notion Web Clipper, and then categorize it under this project. To do this, select your resources as database and click the Save Page button. After completing these steps, you can find the saved data in the Inbox tab of the Resources section. Open the page and select the type of resource. If this resource is related to a project you are currently working on or to your area, you can add it to the relevant project or area through this page. We can then write our own notes or use Notion AI to help us write a summary of this article. If you want to know how to download and set up Notion Web Clipper, you can find download links and tutorials in the LiFE RPG documentation. Archive indicates that an item is currently irrelevant, such as projects, tasks, or resources that are not needed at the moment. We prefer to archive completed projects instead of removing them, because we may have a similar project in the future, which we can refer to by searching for archived projects. I hope you found this video helpful, and you can now better use LiFE RPG to manage and track your daily tasks and projects. In the next video, I will show you how to use LiFE RPG's marketplace, reward system, and mood diary functions, and share the use case of using the reward system in daily life. Thank you, and enjoy your time with LiFE RPG.